Hello everyone, welcome to Renaud Talks IP. What is NMOS? This is a question I receive a lot and I want to address it. So I have to mention before we start that I'm not an expert in NMOS. So, but for more information, please send me the question you have on top of the one you already sent, and I will make sure that I answer them in a Renaud Talks IP. Maybe we can go a little bit deeper in some part of the NMOS topic. So, well, let's go to the 2110. 2110 defined the standards, like how to send packets, like the wide, narrow, like we talked before in the Renaud Talks IP. Define a common transport layer, bandwidth, also synchronization protocol. So, and also the 2110 was done to eliminate a lot of things, distribution amplifier, embedders, and the embedder to elementary stream so you can split the essence. And you remember, we talked about that in a previous one, previous Renaud Talks IP as well. So, but 2110, don't talk about control. Don't talk about how do you discover equipment. So the goal at some point is not to have, you don't want to have to go to all the switches and configure the IP and say, okay, I have a new device in my network. You want this to be discovered. So they started with this. So Amura Group created the NMOS. So they created NMOS IS-04 standard to start, to identify a model, identify your source and destination, but also talk about a discovery workflow. Then they said, okay, cool. Now we know we have a new device in the network. So let's talk about connection API. So that's IS-05. So how to connect to source destination, or more importantly, how to connect destination with, let's say, multiple audio flows, one video and one ancillary and so on and so on. So then we talked about audio flow. I just talked about it a few seconds ago, right? But now we have to assign which audio channel we want to listen. So that's IS-08. So IS-08 enable you to select which audio you want to listen, which AS, which flow, which multicast you want to listen, or unicast. So then they talk about security, because it's really important to make sure that all the signals are protected. And also you don't change the flow you listen to by having a non-secure connection with your device. IS-06 was created after for network control. IS-07 for event and tally, because we know it's important when you do production. So IS-09 was the system. And finally, IS-10 was the authorization. I don't want to go too much in detail on one, all of them, because there's multiple parts in NMOS. You have the big overview. I will talk about what Riedel did to help you with NMOS. So we created the NMOS Explorer. So basically, you can add devices IS-04 compliant in your network, and then you will see them in the Explorer. You can start doing some connection and you can start playing with NMOS. This is available through Riedel.net. We will make sure that you can play with it and you can connect any device that are compliant to IS-04, IS-05. So there's something we did as an industry, as the manufacturer. We sit down together and we define the IS-09, and we also talk about TR-1001. And to enable NMOS in your studios, in your plan, and in your infrastructure, we decided to do to regroup some key technology in TR-1001. We did interop around it, and we certified the TR-1001. So we did 2110 for streaming. We talked about the PTP for timing in 1001. We talked about HDCP. DHCP, it's an old thing in HDMI. So we talked about DNS for address deployment. We talked about IS-04, IS-05 for connection management. We talked also about multicast address appliance to IS-05. And finally, we talked about IS-09 as the system-wide information deployment. So with this, we were able to do some interop. Riedel hosts some interrupts in our headquarters in Wuppertal, and then we were able to certify. This was done in 2019, and we were able to certify multiple vendors. We didn't do it as Riedel, but we did it as an industry, and we're really pleased with to say that the MediaNet IP are compliant with TR-1001. And we'll follow the interrupts, we'll participate to the interrupt to make sure we continue to be compliant. So thank you very much for watching. I hope this 10,000 foot overview of the NMOS was interesting for you and you have curiosity to read a little bit more about it. For more information and more videos, please visit Riedel.net. I'm Renaud. Thank you very much for watching.